Welcome back to the 2011 WFTDA Championships here from Broomfield, Colorado. I'm Double H, and I am joined here by Hydra. Welcome, Hydra.
Thank you very much.
Now, we often hear Texas referred to as sort of the godmothers of the sport. You truly are a godmother of the sport. You are the first president of the WFTDA, one of the founding members, and you were on the original 2006 championship team, the Texas Rollergirls. What is it like to be here, having seen the incarnation of the sport through all these years today?
It's really exciting to be here. I'm so impressed with the level of play and with the venues that we're able to have the tournaments in now. It's so much nicer than playing in the little skating rinks that we started out with in the mid-2000s. And, you know, the number of fans that are watching the games now is super exciting. And one of the things that I'm most impressed with is that we're still able to do this as skaters on our own. So that makes me really happy.
By the skaters, for the skaters.
Absolutely.
Still, to this day.
Still, and it's really important. And so I'm glad to see that that's being maintained.
So, and one of the things that we should note in its first incarnation, nationals, now championships, which speaks to the international flavor of the sport. What does that mean to you?
Oh, I'm just super excited to see that the sport has spread to other countries all across the globe, because it's such a fun game to play, and it's such an empowering sport for women. And to see other countries be able to play with us and enjoy the sport with us is really exciting. And also, you know, more international travel for everybody, which is a lot of fun.
Yeah, that's never a bad thing. Now, the Hydra itself, the trophy that is awarded to the championship team, has been passed from team to team. It started in 2008 in Portland when Rose City and Rat City hosted together. What was your experience like when you learned that the trophy was named after you?
I just cried like a little baby. I was completely surprised. I was kept in the dark on it. And so Cracker Jack, who was the president of the WFTDA at that time, had kept me completely in the dark about the trophy. And so when it was revealed there during the tournament, the ceremony, I just blubbered like a little baby in front of everybody. And so I was just so honored and shocked and surprised and just, you know, it felt really good to get some recognition like that too.
Well, so you retired from the board of directors in 2009, but you are now working with the Rec League.
That's
in
right.
Texas.
That's correct. Yes, I'm still involved a lot with my home league in Austin, Texas, the Texas Rollergirls. After I left the board of the WFTDA, I took a position as the program coordinator for the Texas Rollergirls Recreational and Junior Roller Derby Leagues. So I help get those leagues on track every year. And I even skate in the recreational league myself now. I retired from roller derby in 2006 due to a knee injury, but took several years off and some rehabilitation, and now I'm back on skates, but just at a more, a little bit of a lighter level. And but it's still great to be involved with the roller derby and with the recreational and junior leagues. It feels almost similar to working with the WFTDA in the early days of just trying to bring roller derby to the masses. Back then, hardly anybody knew about roller derby, and we were trying to get the sport known to the public. Now, a lot more people know about roller derby, so now my goal is just to get everybody playing.
So that was my next question too, working with the Rec League and having been on the board of directors and as the president through all of these years, what is your hope for the future of roller derby here?
Well, I'd like to see it continue growing, and I think that it's really important that the skaters stay involved in the organizing of the sport. I'd hate to see the skaters let any of the controls slip out of their hands. And I think that we're on the right track, you know, international play, and the insurance program has been a wonderful thing for the sport and for the WFTDA. So I think just, you know, continue on the path to world domination.
Well, world domination indeed. We're going to start with the championship title, which is coming up next. But first, we're going to see who gets that number three spot. Texas duking it out with Kansas City. We're going to return you to that coverage in just a moment. Again, I'm Double H here with Hydra, and you are watching us live on WFTDA.com.